Greedy peeps, my name is Scribbs, and welcome back to another speed paint. And also another failed challenge, because in the last episode I actually said that I would start recording speed paints or like drawing related videos about 2 times weekly, something that I have not managed to live up on at all. This is actually the only speed paint that I've done this entire week since the last one, so I mean, if that's not enough proof, I don't know what is. And I'm very sorry about that. I do plan to actually get into it at some point. Who knows? Maybe during December. December will be more nice to me. The Christmas spirit will be nice to me. Or who knows? Maybe I'll just hop on the train and say that's gonna be my New Year's resolution. And then we'll get on that. But anyways, let's skip on right into the speed paint, because I know this is one that you've been... Well, I don't know if you've been waiting for it, but you've been at the very least requesting it. Because in the last video, I drew Project Arrhythmia. I drew Project Arrhythmia, or a Project Arrhythmia level called Nautilus, which is a level and also a character from OL666. I think that people actually could just call him OL6x3 or something. I don't know why, but I'm just gonna call him OL from now on. But Nautilus is a song or a level from his level collection. And it's sort of in the middle of it, but it's one of my favorite bosses. It's a really freaking good boss, but once again, it's sort of in the middle of the collection, so I'm actually surprised that people have taken such a liking to it, and that also that Nautilus has actually been playing more of a bigger role in the storyline of the Blackheart collection. Because not only do I think that Aura is underrated, but Aura is also the first boss, I think. Or, well, it's at least the boss that's prior to Nautilus. And I actually think even in the battle where they both fight you, which I believe is the very, very first level, called First Crush, I still think she's the one that appears first, so I don't exactly know why she's the one who's just been frozen in time and isn't gonna play as big of a role in Blackheart for some reason. But I like her, and I'm gonna draw her today, and luckily you guys seem to agree, because after I drew her husbandu, not Nautilus, a lot of you guys seem to be requesting that I drew Aura as well, so we could put them together and have them both in human shape, because that's what this challenge is about. I'm sorry, I actually forgot to tell you that part, but I am gonna take her character design and I'm gonna turn it into a human character design, or at least a human-esque character design. So popping the cork on this design, then we got the most important features that we need to focus on. Because all Project Arrhythmia characters have that in common, that they're extremely minimalistic, which means there's sort of limitations to work with when it comes to creating a human, more detailed character design out of them. But artists usually like working with limitations, so it's not that big of a problem. But the first two big things that I notice when I look at Aura is definitely what they're wearing and what they're also holding. Because Aura wears sort of a witch hat, which helps indicate kind of like what kind of person she is and what kind of abilities she uses during combat. And then she of course has a wand that implicates the almost exact same thing. But this is actually a good thing, because usually those things are all in a set. You usually don't just wear a wizard hat or have a wand on your own, you usually have some wizard's clothing to accustom it, or maybe it's some witch's clothing. I don't know, I just sort of took inspiration from the different sorts of MMORPGs and stuff I could find out there, and all the kind of imprints I already have in my head about what a witch looks like, and then I tried to create it into an outfit that would suit Aura in a way. And one of the things that I found quite interesting was also the blue wand that she's holding. I actually didn't pay attention to that until I viewed the footage back from when I played against her and saw that she's actually holding a blue wand. Now, this influences the drawing in actually quite a few ways. You'd be surprised how these small things can actually have an influence. But the original plan was actually to make her entirely red, or that kind of purplish rouge color that she sort of has. But the blue wand sort of forces me to balance things out, so I have to make a few more details in her drawing blue, but I also thought that this would go really well when she actually stands next to Nautilus, and it also fits because they are a couple, so it would make sense that she does use a little bit of blue in her color, but it ended up mostly being details because I still wanted to maintain that contrast between Nautilus being the blue one and Aura being the more red one. I've actually also watched, what's it called? It's not called My Hero Academia, but it's called The Little Witch Academia, sorry. So that's also why I decided to make the outfit a little bit more schoolgirlish, just because that's sort of the view of a witch that I've gotten used to these the past couple of days. But I kind of like it. I think it fits her to kind of have that schoolgirl demeanor instead of the very calculated, say, like actually decked out level 99 MMORPG wizard style. Overly designed clothing. And also, there's only so far you can go with one design without going overboard, especially when the origins are so simplistic. Then you don't really need to change that much before it starts looking weird. If there was one thing that I regret not doing in this drawing, is the fact that I actually think I even sketched it in, but I removed the gems that I was gonna put on her clothing, or on her little skirt, actually. And I regret it just because that hexagonal shape is just so, like it's just such an important part of her character. And I also regret that I didn't make her shape language, or her body fit her shape language a little more. I wish I made it a little sharper. This seemed just a little more down the road and just sort of my normal cartoonish style. But then again, I will admit, I haven't drawn in a while, which is why I also need to make more of these drawing videos. I'm not getting the practice I need, but yeah, definitely I should have done some more about the shape language. But I did put a few of those hexagons around. I put it, of course, at the end of her staff, because that's also the same as in the game. It's sort of this hexagonal shape. I put it at the top of her dress as sort of a little amulet, and then I tried something sort of experimental, and that's actually because I thought of her boyfriend or husband or whatever, Nautilus. Because Nautilus is underwater themed, and I actually sort of created his human design kind of like he's waltzing around on the depths of the ocean or something. So I actually wanted to sort of... I actually got the idea thinking of an anglerfish, because anglerfish are these deep sea fish monsters that lure in fish with kind of like this little shining bulb at the end of their head. And I actually thought it would be kind of cool to sort of have this bluish appealing crystal hanging from the end of her witch hat in sort of the same manner. And it wasn't necessarily because it's to do with her being underwater as well or anything like that. It's not got any lore or anything to it. I just thought it would be kind of nice to have this little alluring crystal hanging from the end of her hat this way. But anyways, I actually think that's sort of it. I think that's sort of just the design, this schoolgirlish Hogwarts-ish witch who's just sort of alluring, and she's very colorfully pink, while just a little hint of blue to sort of remind her of her boyfriend, which I thought would be kind of sweet. I'm sorry I didn't put too much effort into her design as I did with Nautilus, but at the same time, I almost also thought that Nautilus was a little over-designed, actually, for his very, very, very simplistic design in the game. So I wanted to make it a little more simplistic. That, and it also gives me an excuse to not put as much time into a single design as I did with Nautilus. But I would also like to apologize because I have been a little sick, so I'm sorry if the videos are not exactly up to quality. I'm actually just sort of on my brink here, trying to get a video out every single day. So I'm sorry if they're all sort of subpar, or if I'm not, or maybe if I'm making a few slips of editing here and there. I'm sort of rushing to catch up because I also gotta go on a mini weekend vacation, as I sometimes do. And I would like to have some videos prepared, but there's not even any easy games or anything to record either. So I'm just sort of stuck here doing the videos that actually take a lot of work and a lot of hours in order to make them right. But if you got any ideas for any games I could play or any sort of things I could draw, heck, even fun things we could do during like just a vlog between the two of us, I'm open to pretty much any suggestions. And you know what, a really good suggestion for like a Let's Play or something like that I could just sort of start on the channel, that would probably be the best Christmas present that I could ever wish for, because, well, we are entering December now, so I gotta start making some wishes. And now I've at least given you guys one, so if you guys would like to be my good Santa, I would appreciate a good suggestion. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace.